morning. If it's Tuesday, it's Entrepreneurship Tuesday at Y254 Channel is where you can find us across all our social media handles at Michelle Ashira is where you can find me across all my social. In this particular session, we're diving into an interview that looks at the nail business, the nail parlor sort of kind of business, the all aspect of it. In studio, I'm joined by Christopher and Jenga, who is a nail technician at Chiba Nail Bar.
Yeah.
Got it. Chiba Nail Bar. That is where you find Chris. Warembo na Chris. Thank you very much, Christopher, for creating time to be with us today.
Thank you so much for helping me.
Hey, Chris.
Yes.
So when I say my like life is not perfect, but nails is in as a core perfect.
Yes. Nails are not perfect, but your nails can be perfect.
Yeah, life is not perfect, but my nails can be perfect.
Exactly.
And also the guys, the gentlemen, because now the beauty industry in 21st century is quite different from way back. Now the gentlemen are into grooming much more, you know, they want their cuticles taken care of, manicure, pedicure. Tunio.
Yes.
All right, so Christopher, take us to your life story to the point whereby you decided that, you know, I'm going to be a nail technician, that this is actually what I love and this is what I'm going to do.
Okay, first of all, I'd say thank you for hosting me here.
It's You're very pleasure. Much welcome.
Okay, my name's Chris Njenga, work at Chiba Nail Bar. I run the brand called Warembo na Chris. Basically, when you ask about how I started my business and how I operate my business of Warembo na Chris and yes. the beauty perspective issue, this is a thing I've dealt with it since time Kitambo, because I did art and all that, so I loved expressing my art even through people, and I'm a kind of guy, I'm an extrovert who loves ladies, because I was brought by two lovely sisters and my cousins out there, and I used to like them when they are beautiful and all that, and it's just in me, I just want to see a lady glamorous, mm-hmm. yeah. So I can see that's why what pushed me to beauty industry, to nail industry, because my impression, first of all, is not even a nails first before males.
Mm. Yeah. Ah, okay, repeat that again.
Nails first before males.
Ladies, did you hear that? It is nails before?
Males.
Okay, so how did you gain the skills?
Okay, it's back 2017 where my cousin opened a beauty parlor, and I was there with her because we are good buddies with her. We used to be good buddies, we're still good buddies with her. And so she started mm-hmm. a business because being personal, I am, as in quote unquote, kerere of liking my cousin and all that. Mm-hmm. I saw this an opportunity to work with ladies, because ladies are in my thing, as in I just love ladies and all that. I just love ladies looking out and
looking all glammed
yes,
up.
Yes, yep.
All right. So for someone who's watching this conversation and they've never been to a nail parlor, what does a nail technician actually do in details?
Basically, a nail technician, what a nail technician does, what I do, it's yes. basically making you as a person be able to step out wherever you're going. Maybe it's like you're coming to a studio. I want you to take care of your face bit. I want to take care of your nails. I want to take care of you. When you're going out there for the office work, I want you to be presented, as in to have that confidence. And I'll make sure I make your nails to a point like nobody misses out to see who Michelle is. They want to know, this is Michelle. Look at her nails. If this lady is taking care of her nails, this lady is in another class.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's basically taking care of your nails, taking care of your feet because of pedicure, manicure, and all that. So like you walk with that confidence. You know, when somebody sees you, they will know you've invested in yourself. You went to a nail bar and this nail, a nail shop, they took care of you, took care of your nails, massaged you. You're feeling like
feeling
the
good.
Queen. Yeah.
Yes, feeling like a queen.
Yeah.
Courtesy of Warembo na Chris.
Courtesy of Warembo na Chris.
Okay, let's look at the services that you offer, because I know like when it comes to nails, there are different types of nails and different types of prices that comes with it. So take us through that.
There are different, the way you're saying there are different types of services mm-hmm. Offered in a nail bar. And first of all, we have manicure, whereby you're taking care of your hand and all that from the wrist up here to the shoulder. You have the nail perspective, whereby you have different, there are people who like to do just the natural nails, and there are ladies who want to put on that extra extra image of having long nails, short nails, or those curvy nails, those I don't know what's expressed as in
different shapes of nails, like we can have box or coffin looking like.
Exactly.
Okay, so it's different, different. Whatever I want, that what you're saying is I can get it. You can make my, no, my desire, my vision of particular art, you can make it come to life.
Yes.
For someone who's watching this conversation and they want to get into the same sort of kind of business, how can they gain these particular skills?
First of all, when you want to do this kind of business, it must have a passion, because you're treating a lady who you don't know you'll ever come back. You must have passion. I want Michelle to look glamorous. I must be passionate making Michelle, so that when I'm doing this kind of work, I want to know, what does Michelle want? I must have that passion. I must have the skills. I must go and do the extra. It's not a must. You good. It's good going to school and all those, the different nail schools and all that. But if you don't have the passion, if you don't have the skills, it's totally different.
Okay, let's look at the monetary aspect of it. How do you make your money? When it comes to your first client, how much time do you spend on this client, and also different rating card for your prices for different nails at the nail bar, or even different services?
For the different services that we offer, the different pricing we have, it all depends, again, as I said earlier, it all depends on the services you've done. Because if you're doing tips, tips are like we charge them separately from the normal gel.
Okay.
Because if it is tips and gel, you'll price this particular amount of money, let's say 1500. If it is acrylics, it's 2500. If it's gum gel, 3K and all that. So it all depends on your budget and the kind of service you want.
And how do you make sure that you guys stand out in the market space, considering that this is an industry that has been actually quite very crowded in the market scene? So how do you guys stand out? What is so different about Warembo na Chris?
Okay, what is different about Warembo na Chris is not only about making money, as we're talking about money. Yes, money is good. All businesses must make money. But at the end of the time, what makes me stand out, it's when Michelle comes in, she's not just coming for nails. She's coming there to relax. She's coming there to have her own time. It's between me and as in us two, you see. So that's what makes me stand out. Doing my work to perfection, because I'm a perfectionist. I love when you're out there, you're able to do your nails like, yeah, these are nails you. They're different, because the services I offer, I twist something. Yeah, because everybody can apply gel.
That's
anybody can apply gel. But if you go that extra mile, maybe decoration and all that, yeah.
And speaking about decoration, how do you keep up with the new trends when it comes to art? Because when you head onto Instagram, as you can see on your, we have just seen from your Instagram page, Warembo na Chris, like there's so many different art out there. You just bump into a Facebook, social media, different nails, and you just different art. How do you keep up with the trends?
Keeping up with the trends is gear or step whereby I'm up to date with even the celebrities. What are celebrities doing? I'll check people like Nicki Minaj, Cardi B, and all that. What is their trend? Because I will not stay like those ladies of Kitambo, Wakina Maria Carey, and not what they used to do. They used to do nails, just a plain nail, but at this time, Akina Cardi B are here.
Oh, yeah.
I must make sure.
Now, nails are all expression, expressing who you are, sort of kind of thing. Okay. All right, so we are going through some of your work that is running on our screen. That is Warembo na Chris on Instagram, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Another question that most people ask, especially our parents, when it comes to the long nails, because when you see Cardi B, right, the rapper, when she's all on the music videos with the long nails and everything, do you play a role when it comes to explaining to your client the type of, the length of the nails they should have, or is it a personal decision? And what's your take on, you know, ladies who go for the long nails and their different workspace? Just take us through that.
That's a tough one. But what I would say is when a lady comes and say, I want particular nails, maybe they saw Cardi B, J-Lo, and almost those big names, and they're saying like, I want nails like that. So first of all, I say, okay, I am able to do that. I will do that because you're paying me. But I'll try to figure out, like, I have some nurses, I have some people who are in the food industry and all that. You know, I will not put long nails for them because I know they will struggle. Like doctors, I can't put long nails because of the gloves and all that. Because professionally, you're not supposed to have all those long nails and all that.
Yeah, I don't believe it will be comfortable.
It will not be comfortable.
So it goes back to what you do.
What you do. Mm-hmm. And then I will tell you, if it's an event, of course I'll go out with you, as in the full string. I'll put long nails. So, because, you know, you're having your clutch and all that. You're holding a clutch and the nails. Maybe even here, you're talking
they
to
totally
us, you're expressing
out.
Yourself. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the nails must be long. So that you somebody say, hey, I went to a certain wedding and the nails, did you see the nails? You know, to make you stand out in an event. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And maybe office, because others just, you're typing on your laptop, on your computer and all that. The nails are typing and somebody passes by, then they make your environment different.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what is your strategy when it comes to maintaining your clientele?
My strategy, first of all, is listening to the client. If you come, you tell me you want tips. What kind of tips do you want? What kind of shape do you want? I'll advise you, as in you tell me, I want those long nails, ballerina, I want those long nails, stiletto and all that. I'll listen to you. I'll look at your hands and all that and say, this shape and your nails, they are not matching. So I will advise you, because when I advise you, then when you go out there, you'll come to appreciate and say, wow, Chris advised me on A, B, C, D. So I can trust Chris next time. Okay. Yeah.
All right. So there's a whole strategy around the type of shape of nails you want and your hand, how it looks like. And there's a whole aspect on that.
Yeah. Also color, because you'll come, you say, I saw Michelle with red. And for me, I know your skin tone, as much as you want red, it will not blend with your skin tone.
Okay.
So I'll advise you, say, yes, you want red, we have all those colors, because we have like 100 colors, because it's different priority. And I'll tell you, for this red, it will not match with your hand and all that. So can we adjust? Maybe I'll put you the red one, but I'll twist something on it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's look at the tools of tools of work. I was about to say tools of production.
No problem. Sorry.
Let's look at tools of work that you guys have. Yeah. And is it quite expensive if someone wants to get into this business? And how do they get them? If you even get, take us through what we have on set.
Okay. About pricing and all that, it all depends again on your budget starting the business. Because you have this big palace and you know the kind of the tools they use. They're not the kind like to be found everywhere. So, but what I'll say, if you you want to invest in this, make sure you go, you don't go up high. I'm not saying you don't go there,
mm-hmm.
but again, have the tools that will make your clients comfortable. They'll look like you have invested. Like for us, and I'm not marketing Blue Sky and all that, our shop, Shiva Nail Bar, we normally like prioritize on Blue Sky because we know Blue Sky will never disappoint us. You know, when a client hears that you're doing Blue Sky and the charges that you're doing, they are comfortable. When it comes to buffer, what buffer are you using? Because it will determine if you're buffing the nails, the client nails and all that is happening. The client will feel this thing is so rough, this thing is too, as in it's breaking and all that, it's not standard and all mm-hmm. that. So it all depends on that. And again, you go to the right companies that they offer, because you can do all that research. It is there on the internet.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and that just good quality, make sure that you retain your clientele at the end of the day. So take us through what you have on set now. What is this particular white object and what does it do?
This particular white object is called UV.
Thank you.
It's for drying gel.
Yes.
And basically, because gel is not like normal polish or Q-tex as we used to know it in back in the days.
Mm-hmm.
When you've been applied gel needs to manicure as in and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So it needs to be connected to the power source and all that. So it is the one that we'll use to like kausha the gel polish.
All right.
And then we have the buffer. Mm-hmm. The buffer is basically to buff your nails after we're filing and all that, to make them, to make gel able to have a good base for it to come and sit mm-hmm. on it, so that the gel does not look rough on you, the nails look polished and all that. And then we have the gel itself. and other tools that are not here, mm-hmm. but we have the gel that it's there. That's the color that you have, mm-hmm. and we're saying like in Chiva Delba, where Rembrandt and Chris, we have like 100 colors. So you spoil for choice.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So these are just the basic required tools that one needs when it comes to this sort of business.
There are files, there are nail cutters, mm-hmm. and all that.
Okay, so what are a couple of challenges that you're facing?
Challenges, basically, as in, I don't know what you mean by challenges, as in the market, personally.
Okay, in the business, that is.
Challenges we're facing is like there's a lot of imitation of things. Mm-hmm. And that's why I was saying, when you're going for these tools and all that, make sure you've done your due research. You know this if it is gel, if I apply this gel, what are people saying about it? Because the challenges that are there's a lot of imitation in the market, mm-hmm. but you need to step up as a business owner, as a nail bar owner. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So those are the challenges that are there. And again, apart from you, as in ladies, not you, but not all other ladies, like, you've invested in so much, and the price that you put, somebody thinks like, no, this is too much. They compare you to the other places that they were.
Yes.
But if you go back and do the research from other places, you'll come to realize, yes, that the other place is so cheap and all that, and it's good to be cheap and all that, but at what expense? Do I want to use good stuff to you, or I just want to rush in the shop and buy something that 2 weeks you'll say, Chris, you messed my nails up.
Okay, yeah, so
those are the kind of challenges that
I have. You put your clients' interest at heart, not just business as usual.
Yeah.
Okay, what is the best feeling ever after you've worked on a client and they have responded? So what is the best response that you've ever gotten from a client?
The best response is like compliments. Mm-hmm. You feel somebody is tagging you on Instagram, Facebook and all that, and they say, these are my nails done by, even they say, visit my nail plug, mm-hmm. and all that. So it's a compliment, somebody was satisfied, and that's what pushes me.
So client satisfaction.
Satisfaction.
So that's it. Warembona Chris.
Yeah, Warembona Chris.
All right. So how can guys find you across all social media handles if they want to reach out to you, get their nails done, pedicure, manicure, facial, all that?
On Instagram, I'm at Warembo _na_Chris. That is Warembo na Chris. But if you'll forget those underscores, if you just type # Warembo na Chris, mm-hmm. everything will come there.
Everything pops up.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much. Santi Sana, Christopher Njenga, for creating time to be with us, taking us through what a nail parlor looks like in terms of different art that you've also gotten to see from your social media handles. Santi Sana.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. That is Warembo na Chris, Warembo na Chris with Christopher Njenga. So make sure you catch up with him across all social media handles. That is Warembo na Chris, and you can reach out to him and he got you. He's your plug when it comes to the nails. That is pedicure, manicure, facial, anything, everything when it comes to being glammed up as a lady. Head on to Warembo. Now, Chris, so it's finally our time frame at 10. So this is the end of the show. So make sure you create time next Tuesday, same time frame from 7 till 10 a.m. at Y254 channel is where you can find us across all our social media handles. At Michelle Ashira is where you can find me across all my socials. So make sure you create time, Create time next Tuesday, same time frame. All right, so enjoy the rest of your day. Keep it right here on Y254 channel, the number one youth station. So make sure you stick around, because there's so much more when it comes to programs right here. Have a nice day. Take care.